Lecture 2, Academic Writing, the topic sentence. Objectives: to learn how to define the topic sentence, to learn how to write supporting sentences, and to learn how to write concluding sentences. The questions: the first, position of topic sentence. The second question, supporting sentences, and the concluding sentence. So let's talk about position of topic sentence. The topic sentence states the main idea of the paragraph. It not only names the topic of the paragraph, but it also limits the topic to one specific area that can be discussed completely in the space of a single paragraph. The part of the topic sentence that announces the specific area to be discussed is called the controlling idea. Every paragraph has a topic sentence, which clearly states the topic and the controlling idea of the paragraph. A topic sentence is the most important sentence in a paragraph. It shows what the paragraph is going to discuss. For this reason, the topic sentence is a helpful guide to both the writer and the reader. The writer, for example, can see what information to include and what information to exclude. The reader can see what the paragraph is going to be about and is therefore better prepared to understand it. And here, three important points to remember about a topic sentence. So, first important point. Look at these points, please. First, a topic sentence is a complete sentence. That is, it contains at least one subject and one verb. Second, a topic sentence contains both a topic and a controlling idea. It names the topic and then limits the topic to a specific area to be discussed in the space of a single paragraph. And the third important point is that a topic sentence is the most general statement in the paragraph because it gives only the main idea and it does not give any specific details. The topic sentence is usually, but not always, the first sentence in a paragraph. Experienced writers sometimes put topic sentences in other locations, but the best spot is usually right at the beginning. Readers who are used to the English way of writing usually want to know what they will read about as soon as they begin reading. What is a topic sentence? A topic sentence states the main point of a paragraph. It serves as a mini thesis for the paragraph. You might think of it as a signpost for your readers or a headline, something that alerts them to the most important interpretive points in your essay. When read in sequence, your essay's topic sentences will provide a sketch of the essay's argument. Thus, topic sentence will help protect your readers from confusion by guiding them through the argument. But topic sentences can also help you to improve your essay by making it easier for you to recognize gaps or weaknesses in your argument. Where do topic sentences go? Topic sentences usually appear at the very beginning of a paragraph. Sometimes writers save a topic sentence for the end of a paragraph. You may, for example, occasionally find that giving away your point at the beginning of a paragraph does not allow you to build your argument toward an effective climax. Let's consider the questions. How do I come up with a topic sentence? And what makes a good one? Ask yourself, what's going on in your paragraph? Why have you chosen to include the information you have? Why is the paragraph important in the context of your argument? What point are you trying to make? Relating your topic sentences to your theories can help strengthen the coherence of your essay. If you include a thesis statement in your introduction, then think of incorporating a keyword from that statement into the topic sentence. So, don't forget these questions and pay attention to them. How do I come up with a topic sentence? What makes a good one? Ask yourself what's going on in your paragraph. Why have you chosen to include the information you have? Why is the paragraph important in the context of your argument? Next. So I also want to ask you not to forget that your topic sentence should do more than just establish a connection between your paragraph and your thesis. Use a topic sentence to show how your paragraph contributes to the development of your argument by moving it that one extra step forward. If your topic sentence merely restates your thesis, then either your paragraph is redundant or your topic sentence needs to be reformulated. If several of your topic sentences restate your thesis, even if they do so in different words, then your essay is probably repetitive. So let's talk about topics. Topics are important to both, as we have already said, to both readers and writers. Identifying the topic of a paragraph helps readers to understand what it is about. Choosing focused topics helps writers focus their thoughts and organize their ideas. And you already know that the topic is the general subject of an entire paragraph. Every sentence in a paragraph in some way discusses or explains this topic. To find the topic of a paragraph, ask yourself, what is the one idea the author is discussing throughout the paragraph? The first step in writing an effective paragraph is to select a topic that you are knowledgeable and comfortable writing about. It is worth spending time to think of possible topics and to discover what you know about each before making a selection and beginning to write. And to write a good paragraph, you need a manageable topic, one that is the right size. Your topic must be general enough to allow you to add interesting details that will engage your reader. It must also be specific or narrow enough that you can cover it adequately in a few sentences. If your topic is too general, you will end up with a few unrelated details that do not add up to a specific point. And if your topic is too narrow, you will not have enough to say. Don't forget about these points, please. So let's speak how to write an effective paragraph. Look at these words and please. An effective paragraph, comfortable writing, a good paragraph, and manageable topic. So let's continue the lecture with the problem of supporting sentences. Supporting sentences explain or prove the topic sentence. One of the biggest problems in student writing is that student writers often fail to support their ideas adequately. They need to use specific details to be thorough and convincing. There are several kinds of specific supporting details, examples, statistics, and quotations. Supporting sentences usually give information that explains and expands the topic of the paragraph. They answer questions who, what, where, when, why, and how, and give details. Good writers think of these questions when they write supporting sentences for the topic sentence. And please pay attention to kinds of supporting sentences. Good supporting sentences have different goals. Writers vary them to explain. The family moved from the village to the capital for economic reasons. To describe, she lived in a lovely three-story castle surrounded by a forest. To give reasons, Lucas finally quit his job because of the stressful working conditions. To give facts, more than 10% of the university student population is international, and etc. To give examples and to define. So what is the concluding sentence? So let's continue our lecture, and a paragraph does not always need a concluding sentence. For single paragraphs, especially long ones, a concluding sentence is helpful to the reader because it is a reminder of the important points. However, a concluding sentence is not needed for every paragraph in a multi-paragraph essay. And there are three important points. A good topic sentence is the first important point. So, what is a good topic sentence? It is a complete sentence with a subject, a verb, and a controlling idea. It is neither too general nor too specific. It clearly states the main idea of the paragraph, but does not include specific details. It is usually the first sentence in the paragraph. The second important point. Good supporting sentences explain or prove the topic sentence. They are specific and factual. They can be examples, statistics, or quotations. And the third, a good concluding sentence signals the end of the paragraph, summarizes the important points briefly, and restates the topic sentence in different words. And let's speak about the following transitional words and phrases which are commonly used at the beginning of a concluding sentence. They are as a result, overall, for this reason, certainly, because of this, surely, in conclusion, therefore, for these reasons, clearly, thus, in brief. Pay attention at these transitional words and phrases, please, and please use them at the beginning of concluding sentence. A concluding statement can offer a suggestion, give an opinion, or make a prediction. Sometimes a concluding statement does a combination of these three options. The concluding sentence is the last sentence of the paragraph. It concludes a paragraph. It lets the reader know that you have finished talking about the idea introduced by the topic sentence. A concluding sentence often has one of these four important purposes. It restates the main idea. It offers a suggestion. It gives an opinion. It makes a prediction. And then at the end of this lecture, I would like to ask you questions. So the first question, what does a topic sentence show? Think about topic sentence and please Try to answer this question. The second, what sentence is the most important sentence in a paragraph? So we have spoken about topic sentence and another sentences, and you have to decide what sentence is the most important sentence in a paragraph. The next question, what sentence is usually but not always the first sentence in a paragraph? And what do you need to write a good paragraph? Think about these questions and please try to answer them. So, these are sources which you have to use in order to prepare to your practical lessons. So, thank you for attention.